with the fallout about controversy falling out from last week's Prime, ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you tonight to ACL Prime 113. As we heard at the beginning of the night, before we came on this evening, we will be hearing from the current Prime General Manager at the end of the evening to discuss the effects as to what happened at the end of last Prime. Because, ladies and gentlemen, while we do have a lot in terms of Sky High Division matches now, with this specifically, ladies and gentlemen, we will be making the final decision on Noctis Lucius Kyalem's vacation of the Sky High Championship. But not only that, ladies and gentlemen, tonight we will be getting started on what is being known as the Sky High Tournament to decide a new Sky High Champion at the All-Star Grand Slam. And it's all going down with all this and much, much more tonight on Prime. As usual, I'm your host for this evening. I am your voice of the All-Star Calling, Mr. Bradley James, at your service for this evening. And we're kicking things off in a big way. It seems as though the first contest for the Sky High Tournament is going to be involving a former champion of the Sky High Division in his own right, in Lucia right here tonight in the first opening contest of this evening. Not only that, but we will also be having the second of our number one contendership matches to decide who will be facing off against each other at Final Hour for a shot at the crossover championship at the Grand Slam. You already know Haseo will be facing off against the winner of the match tonight between Kaji Tatsumi and Nekomaru Ninai in one of our matches of this evening tonight. And here comes a man who definitely does have quite possibly one of the biggest methods to prove himself in this tournament especially. And that is the sniper of the Hoshino royal family, Takumi. A lot of people have said Takumi has been overdue for a shot at the Sky High title for a while now. Many have said that he has been overdue for a shot, and he has been overdue for a chance to really prove himself as a member of the division. So in something like this, he could most certainly prove himself right here in this opening contest and the opening round match of this tournament. This, in essence, could be big on all fronts for Takumi. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We're getting it started from the word go. These two go for the car over time to start us off right here tonight. Lucio taking full advantage with that headlock in position right there. And Lucio taking no prisoners right there from the word go here. Here in the opening minutes, and Takumi entertaining with a shot to the head, and now gone for it again with a hit and circumstance right there with Takumi, and oh, wait a minute, armbar laying it thick onto Lucio in these opening moments, just like that, not even allowing him to roll out to the outside. He's that focused. And Takumi definitely showcasing in pure form right here in the opening minutes why he may have been overlooked for so long, but why he's not going to be overlooked in this tournament with this intense chance to essentially have the button of the Sky High Championship reset. It's something in a sense that we've never seen happen for any belt in the All-Star Call League, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, this is a circumstance where we've never seen this happen. So to see it happen in this regard, and to see it happen like this, to where this is happening just here and now, speaks volumes, ladies and gentlemen. It speaks volumes as to what's going on. Oh! as to the importance of not just the division as a whole, but to everyone that is included in these matches. And you can see Lucio pulling out everything in the book that made him a sky-high champion to begin with. And there may be a chance he may be able to walk into the Grand Slam the opposite way he walked into it last year when he walked into it. Oh my god! Lucio showcasing why he was sky-high champion walking into the Grand Slam a year ago. And he could walk out of it a champion again. Supersonic Roundhouse! And now, sizing it up, bringing Takumi up for air, but not for too long, because he's about to hit him with a little bit of the crossfade. No! Crossfade denied! And now Takumi setting it up! Burning arrow just like that! And no! Flapjacked onto the ropes just like that! And now, setting it up again. Oh, and a springboard elbow drop denied. Springboard elbow drop denied. Just like that. And now Takumi going up top. Is he faking a sniper shot? Is he about to end it just like that? Oh! Went for the sniper shot, but delivered a headbutt right to the shoulder! Couldn't even hook it into place! And now, it's back into position. Lucio back up and running right here and now, going back into it! And now sizing it up again, and oh wait a minute! Schoolboy into an enziguri! And he's showing that finesse. He is showing that ability. Purely and simple. This is what made him champion at Takumi. Is showcasing why he's having to stick it out. And oh! The combination just like that into the pin too. And now Lucio. No! Knee denied. And now Takumi setting him down, wailing on that head for good measure as well. But continuously finding a way to keep on getting up. And oh my god, oh my god! I've seen that happen so many times this year, but goddamn does it never get easier to see that happen. Just dropping your opponent back first onto the apron. And now going up top again. No! Double foot stomp denied and no! Supersonic Roundhouse denied right there into a bulldog. Now picking him up again, putting him into place just like that, and oh, wait a minute, gut wrench, oh! Gut wrench suplexing him just like that, but Lucio ain't down for the count just yet. And a supersonic roundhouse again, hitting that target. And no! And the beat drop denied from the top. Takumi's chances are still alive. Going for the gut wrench suplex again. And now, Takumi going up top. If he can hit the sniper shot onto Lucio, that may seal his fate right here and now. No! Lucio caught him and slammed him right back down again, but no! Lucio not allowed it. No! Snap suplexed him just like that into the ropes, but the ring position was too much and a rope break saves Lucio's chances. But for how long is Takumi going to be able to keep this up? How much longer is Lucio going to be able to keep it into place? As you can see, he's already busted the hell up right now. It's not looking too bright for Lucio at the moment. And Takumi. Takumi's no longer playing around. He's going right for the big shots. And he's, oh my god, diving through the ropes and sending Lucio right to the outside. And now Takumi, and no! Lucio defiantly stopping him in place and keeping him down for the count. Keeping him from going down just yet. And this is still going on. And, oh! And oh, wait a minute, oh, and another supersonic roundhouse again. And we could just be getting close to the end. Is Lucio faking a crossfade here? If he hits this, this could be it. No! Once again, the crossfade denied. Lucio's offense has been denied throughout this match. He has not gotten a single shot in. And just like that. And now Lucio back up and oh, Meteora. Meteora and no, Lucio denying it again. And now Lucio back into position, sizing him up once more again. And now Lucio ducking under and oh, and a clothesline lead, setting him right back down again. And Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen, Lucio may only have one more chance. If he can't even hit the crossfade with this, this may be it. He hits the crossfade. Crossfade hits the target square onto Takumi. And now, one, two. And he kicks out. He kicks out of it just like that. And now Takumi! Ramming knee just like that. Lucio's head is not looking good right now, ladies and gentlemen. And Takumi's taking full advantage of it. Going up top just like that. And he's setting it up. Sniper shot! Sniper shot just like that. And that could be game, set, match. Right there for Lucio. One, two, three. And Takumi with an impressive victory tonight gets the first win and therefore the first points in this entire tournament. To put it simply, ladies and gentlemen, Takumi has started off the tournament in a huge way. And this could most certainly be a sign of things to come in this tournament. And this may be one of the competitors to look out for the most. Because if Takumi can pull out a performance like this, there may be hope for someone like him to go all the way in this tournament. And possibly even be Sky High champion finally.
Did you not see Apocalypse War?
Oh,
I am the third
one.
Is it an actual?
It's an actual Big Mac!
It's the drizzles.
And we are back here on Prime, ladies and gentlemen. And after one hell of an opener there, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting set for the next contest of the evening. And my God, what a next contest of the evening is it going to be? Because this is the second half of the crossover championship number one contendership qualifier, where the winner of this match will face off against Haseo at Final Hour for a shot at the crossover championship. And the winner of that match will face off against the current champion, Chris. If he is still champion by the Grand Slam, he will face off against the winner of the match at Final Hour. And this match is going to decide whether it will be Kaji Tatsumi or if it will be Nakamaru Nidai facing off against him at Final Hour. And now we await Kaji Tatsumi. What? Kaji's laying out backstage and... Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Don't you dare tell me who I think it is, ladies and gentlemen! Oh, you've gotta be kidding me! Of course it was Jotaro Kujo! You know what? I'm not even remotely surprised anymore over the situation that's been brewing between Jotaro and Kaji, because this has been going on for months now. It's no longer a matter of if these two hate each other to such a degree, it's just what the hell's gonna happen next between these two. Because it seems like every other week, there's shit going down between these two, and it always somehow comes back to the other party being involved. And don't tell me I'm just being stupid about this or being paranoid, because this has been going on for a damn long time now. Nevertheless, ladies and gentlemen, this has turned from Kaji versus Nidai into Jotaro versus Nidai. So I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, this is quite possibly going to be a massive encounter between these two, regardless of the fact that it was meant to be Kaji Tatsumi in this match. This matchup alone is a big money encounter that we've only seen once in the past. We've only seen this happen once in the past. And my God, that was during the time when Nakamaru Nidai was still running roughshod back on Millennium. But now, these two are going absolutely nuts over each other. And how the tables have turned since the last time that these two... But as you can see, Nidai is just venting out the frustration. He was probably looking forward to the contest between him and Kaji. And now all this bullshit's going on. And now, as you can see right now, Nidai obviously not wanting to give Jotaro Kujo the satisfaction of allowing him to go to Final Hour to face off against Haseo. But you can definitely see it in his eyes. He's got a lot more on his mind as well. He's still one half of the tag team champions alongside Gun Tanaka. And you really gotta be wondering if that's gonna be affecting his mindset going into the future with these matches as well. But I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, as we're seeing right here now, and oh my God! Jotaro is definitely bringing it out against Nidai right here and now, but Nidai, on the other hand, definitely not wanting to allow him to have that satisfaction right here and now tonight. But as you can see, Jotaro is definitely taking the advantage of this contest so far, but Nidai, despite the size differences on all fronts, is more or less trying his damn best to keep Jotaro down. Whether or not he's successful at, it's It has yet to be seen. But as you can see, oh, wait a minute. Neon is about to set him up. Jordan, despair bomb. One. Only managing a one count with that. Amazingly, only managing a one count with that. But as you can definitely see, these two going after each other just from the opening moment. But it seems as though, wait a minute, Neon is a, oh my god! Torture rack, neck breaker, just like that. You can definitely see Jordan bringing it out right there onto Nidai, not allowing even a fraction of space, or even allowing it to go down without much of a fight, but no! Nidai reversing every opportunity for Jordan. But wait a minute, package pile driver just like that. And hard-hitting lariat just like that right there by Jotaro. But you can definitely tell he's not done yet. But Nidai sizing to give up once again for another package pile driver just like that again. Another package pile driver just like that. And a despair bomb, a second one. One, two. A second despair bomb just like that, and Nidai's back on the offensive. But as you can see right here, even when Jotaro is managing to pull out everything against him, Nidai still somehow manages to find a way out of it. And that's the resiliency that we've come to expect from a man like Nekomaru Nidai over the last few years. But Jotaro, on the other hand, Jotaro is bringing out everything against him. Single-legged Boston Crab being one of them up against him right here and now. Just applying the pressure right to that leg, right there onto Nekomaru Nidai, and shoving him off just like that. But of course, Jotaro definitely not wanting to go down without much of a fight. You can see it in his face. But Nidai setting him up for another. But no! Jotaro not allowing him for a third time with the package pile driver. And now Jotaro sizing him up. And oh! Over heaven! And hitting him with over heaven, just like that. One, two, and only a two count. Nidai barely kicking out of that over heaven. But you can definitely tell Jotaro is primarily in the driver's seat right now. Oh, but he just busted him open just like that. That may be a bad sign right there for Jotaro. Elbowing him right to the chest. And no! Jotaro not going down. But Jotaro definitely may be in a good position for the win right here and now. And you can definitely tell Jotaro's just having a bit of fun at this point. Throwing him around at this point like a rag doll. And you can see it right in his face. Wailing down on Nidai like nothing else, completely destroying the former Millennium Champion and one half of the current Tag Team Champions, and no! Nidai still not going down, about a fight! And you can definitely see that Nidai, even after taking all brunts of the damage from there, and you can see, but no! Shodaro still managing to find an opening just like that, and managing to take advantage of it, but no! Nidai reversing opportunity after opportunity to wear down onto him. As you can see, Jotaro seemingly is just fed up at this point. He's not even taking that much pleasure in the situation anymore. He's just wanting to end it for good measure at this point. And Nidai is still fuming. Nidai's just still fuming over it all. He's looking to put him down, but no! Not even allowing that! Not even allowing that! And once again, going right back for it again, sizing him up for a gut wrench, deadlift, suplex, setting him down for the... And now, sizing him up. He's about to set him up and lay him down for a star! And he's star platinum, a star platinum just like that. And that may be it for Nakamura Nidai. 1, 2, 3. My God. My God. My God. That has got to be painful with what we've seen in this match. But my God, ladies and gentlemen, did Nakamura Nidai pull out a massive fight right here tonight. But at final hour now, it'll be Jotaro Kujo facing off against Haseo for a shot at the crossover title at the Grand Slam. And let me tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, that match in a nutshell, you better be hoping and praying that Haseo makes out of it in one piece. Because if what we saw right here tonight is any indication, then Jotaro Kujo is a walking death machine in action at this point, and he ain't taking no prisoners anymore. And that's for damn certain. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, going right back in for our next Sky High Tournament match. And, well, of course this man would have to be in the tournament. Of course this little shit would have to show up eventually in this tournament. But I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, considering the talent pool in this tournament, it's going to be a miracle if he manages to make it to the Grand Slam, because the division has seemingly grown a fair bit since he first came into it, and since he sold it out to become a part of Spiral. But ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you what right now, Black Star being in this tournament's no surprise. But all I hope is that he barely even scratches the surface in this tournament, because that way, he doesn't get closer to being champion again. But this man on the other hand has been making some real good shockwaves within the Sky High Division. And the big boy of the Sky High Division, the chosen Keyblade Warrior, Terra, right here tonight may possibly be the wild card, be one of the hugest wild cards in this whole tournament. Cause my God, him amongst the three that have come in this year and made shockwaves throughout the entire division may be the ones to really look out for when it comes to this tournament. And that's saying a lot given the talent pool. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen, going right at it for the word going on. Lax already getting a bit too big for his Bruce right there as he gets the opening shot right here in this match. And no! Misses the springboard crossbody and oh! Bridging German just like that. But I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, the fact that this match is happening so early on in the tournament definitely says a lot about the selection for the first matches in this tournament. Because let me tell you what, with what we're seeing right here and now between Takumi and Blackstar, and Blackstar seriously thinks that trying to taunt at Takumi in the middle of a match and then not get his shit kicked in for it is definitely a good idea. Oh great. Oh honey, that's not gonna work for you. That is not gonna work for you. But Blackstar still wailing down with his boots right to the chest. But you can definitely see it in his face that Terra is just waiting for that opportunity and definitely just waiting for an opening to just wail into it for good measure as well. And no! But Blackstar, on the other hand, he's made an entire career out of being a sneaky bastard. He's made an entire year and a half out of being one as well, ever since he joined up with Spiral. But I'll tell you what, Terra is taking him to a place where he's never had to go before, and that's facing off against an absolute powerhouse in the division as a whole. But you can definitely see it in Terra right now. He's not one to be taken lightly. But you can definitely see Blackstar taking a full advantage right here in this match. And now taking full advantage, but no! Terra getting out of it again. Oh! And a back, spinning back elbow just like that. And that's pretty much been the story of the match. Blackstar takes advantage for like a second, and then Terra takes it right back. Oh! Beautiful double rotation moonsault, and one, two, only a two count, just like that. Only getting a damn two count, just like that. And now Terra's back in the driver's seat at this point. And an earth-shattering Lariato, just like that. And but Blackstar getting back up, trying to keep him wear down, just like that. And instead bringing him up for a sliced bread number one. One, two, only a one and a half. But wait a minute, what on earth is Terra got in store right here? Another double rotation! A double 450 just like that. And wait a minute, Blackstar rolls him up, but he's got the ropes. But Terra's back up, and he's on the assault again, but Blackstar wailing into him once more. But of course, Terra finding a way to get into it again, sizing him up one more time, and oh, flapjacking him down just like that. And now Sizer up, and no, Blackstar not allowing it, and he's just taunting away, and oh, and he gets a spine buster right for his troubles. One, only a one count. Only a damn one count. Just like that. Only a damn one count, going right back onto it. Blackstar with that elevated DDT off the ropes. And now, oh, a despicable maneuver with that eye rake and then the high kick right to the head. And now he's just dragging Terror right away from the ropes. And we know exactly what he's trying to go for here. He's thinking of a downward spiral tap just like that to close it all off right here. This could be it for Terror if this hits. And Terror gets out of it. And Terror gets out of it just like that. But what on earth is Terror faking now to wear him down? Oh! Oh! Sending Blackstar to the outside. And wait a minute! He's gonna fly! Oh my god! Don't you dare tell me that a big boy like Terror can't fly high like the rest of the division! Cause guess what? He's showing everyone why even the big boys do get a little bit of that, do have a little bit of that energy to fly sometimes. And now he's going right back, but Blackstar somehow managed to get out of it. No, and a crossbody barely scrapes onto Terror. Oh, and a stiff neck breaker going for the pin. One, two. Only a two count. Only a two count. But he's going right back onto it. He's stomping him down. Stomping him down, going right back to it. And oh my god, a burning hammer from out of nowhere. A fucking burning hammer right there by Blackstar, right there onto Terror. Calling a move of desperation. But I'll tell you what right now, ladies and gentlemen. Blackstar may be trying to pull out everything in the book. And oh, wait a minute. He just assaulted the referee. Wait a minute. What on earth is Blackstar pulling out of his pocket just like that? And oh, wait a minute. Oh! He just hit him with a goddamn brass knuckle. Up the referee now. He's gonna try and steal this win, goddammit. One. Two. Terror manages to kick out. Amazingly, he still manages to kick out even after everything. And he's going right back for it. But Blackstar may have already had so much of the damage done to him at this point that it may just be a matter of time going for it again. No! Downward spiral tap denied again, and oh! An elbow drop just like, and just a non-lariat just like that. But what has Terror got in store? Another double rotation moonsault from the top of the rope. An amazing, amazing display of athleticism on the part of the chosen Keyblade Warrior. And he's screaming at him, I'm not done yet. He was screaming at him, I'm not done yet. And he's certainly not done, because he's setting him up for Gaia's Bane! One, two, three! And Terror! Terror is on the scoreboard! He's on the scoreboard alongside Takumi in the opening rounds of this tournament! God! God! Damn! But Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen! Jesus Christ! considering how much Blackstar went to try and keep Terra down. This is why I'm saying he's one of the ones to look out for in this whole shebang of the tournament, because he may be one of the tougher ones to beat, and because of that, he may be one of the few that may make it to that ending match at the Grand Slam.
Touching myself tonight.
And we're back here on Prime, ladies and gentlemen. And in the main event tonight, this is going to be a big contest. Because we already found out back on Millennium that at Final Hour there's going to be a tag team match wherein one member, one tag team of Prime and one tag team of Millennium will face off, and the winners of that match will get a tag team title match of their choosing between Millennium and Prime at the Grand Slam. You already found out that Brave Asperia is going to be part of that as well, but right here tonight, we're about to find out who the Prime team is going to be joining Brave Asperia on that night. Of course, you really do gotta take into consideration, especially given what we were going through, especially given what the DigiDestined happened up to over the last 12 months, essentially, that you would imagine that given the fact that Ty had had a world championship match earlier this year, that the DigiDestined are not going anywhere anytime soon. I mean, they walked into last season with the Millennium Tag Team belts. Who's to say if they win tonight and win at Final Hour, they don't try and go back over to Millennium and win those titles again, right back from, right there, back from, well, the current champions of Doom and Destruction. But ladies and gentlemen, this is your main event, a tag team contest between the Q Rangers, Lucky and Stinger, and the DigiDestined, Ty and Matt. And already you can definitely see that Ty is more or less taking full control of the contest right there from the opening moments, and they're going right back to it again. And Ty is pushing him right back into the ropes again. You can definitely, but I'll definitely say this about the Q Rangers, that has definitely needed to be said for a while now. Despite their win-loss record, despite their track record in ring, the heart and soul that these two members of the Hue Rangers have brought out in tag team action has definitely showcased why they are worthy of being in the same league. But I'll definitely tell you this right now, right here and now, going up against a team like Ty and Matt in this type of contest is getting a win over them is a huge honor in and of itself, because they've essentially been here since the very beginning. They've hung with some of the best tag teams that the entire division as a whole, even prior to the splitting of Millennium and Prime, has definitely seen over the last few years. And getting a win over them in general is definitely an honor. So if the Hue Rangers do manage to get a win like that, especially with such an importance like this, it would be big for them leading into such an event like Final Hour, and possibly as well the Grand Slam if they were to win. But again, this is all speaking hypothetically given the situation. We don't even know just yet if that is even going to be the case. But as we see right here and now, Stinger of the Hue Rangers definitely bringing it out for as much as he possibly can against their opponents. But you can definitely see that Ty and Matt definitely are taking no prisoners in this. But Ty going to the outside now. But wait a minute, Stinger found that opening just like that. But no, Ty trying to find it again. And continuing to wail down onto him just like that. And Stinger shoving Ty into the corner now. And oh! Delivering stomp after stomp right there into the corner. And just continuing to wail away specifically right there onto Ty into that corner. That's definitely a pretty easy way to just weaken him down specifically just like that. Oh, and a drop kick right there by Lucky. One. Oh! And Matt pulling out a move of desperation and going all in and assaulting the ref, trying to break up the pin. And now Lucky trying to bring up the ref again, and now going right back to going down to Ty at this point. Oh! The tide is shifting very quickly onto the side of the Hue Rangers now. After that assault onto Ty, Ty needs to make the tag to Matt soon. He needs to make it, otherwise it may already be game, set, match for him right here and now. And just like that, making the tag to Matt, and oh! Getting Pearl Harbor just like that right there by Lucky. And of course, making the tag back into Ty. Just as easy as he was brought back in, Ty's already brought back into the ring right now. And a shoulder block tackle right there, just like that. And now Lucky looking to set him up for a super. For an Orion Smash! Orion Smash just like that by Lucky, going for the pin. One! Once again, Matt going for the breaking up the pin at the cost of the referee, but goddamn, Lucky bringing up the ref for air, going for the pin. One! Two! And Matt breaks it up again. And And of course, Ty back up to his feet once again. Ty back up to his feet again. But this is the thing you've also got to keep in mind with an opponent like Ty in the ring right now, is that any amount of an opening he will take advantage of. Oh! But this is the thing as well. You cannot allow your opponent in a situation like this to keep the opening up as much as possible. But here we go. Oh, and a double backstabber just like that by Lucky. And Stinger into place just like that. And Lucky. And Stinger, on the other hand, taking advantage of this now. Meanwhile, Matt's been tagged into the ring. Oh! Intercepted with a clothesline just like that. And this is the thing as well with this. And oh, wait a minute. Stinger pulling out No Mercy right there onto Matt. No Mercy at all right there onto Matt on the outside. And oh, wait a minute. Oh, tackling him down just like that. Tackling him down just like that and shoving Matt right back into the ring. But now Matt could be in danger. He could be in a huge lot of danger right here and now. If Stinger gets his way, and no! Matt on the other hand sizing him up. Wild Heartbreaker just like that. And now Stinger trying to recoup it at this point. But no! Right there to the head of Matt Ishida. And now continuing to just continue to wail in on that head. Obviously trying to go for poison choke at some point. But Stinger going right back, trying to wear him down as much as possible. Matt, on the other hand, finding opening after opening, getting it by the wrist. But here we go. But this, ladies and gentlemen, could be the decider right here. If the Q Rangers actually want to be able to get a solid victory right here and now, they need to pull out an all-star crash or something onto one of them. But if the DigiDestined managed to pull out Transcendent Tombstone onto them, that's it. You can just say bye-bye right there to the Q Rangers' chances. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is not looking good for the Q Rangers right here and now. It's not looking good for them. Ty's directly in the driver's seat at this point. And it looks as though we may be closing in for it now. This is what I feared. This is what I was talking about before. Here it comes. Transcendent Tombstone! And Lucky breaks it up. But Lucky's down and out. Lucky's down and out on the outside. Stinger's still down for the count. 1, 2, 3. But God damn. God damn, ladies and gentlemen. The Q Rangers put up a damn good fight against the DigiDestined. But at the end of the night, at the end of it all, when the chips were laid down flat and in a position like this where it was all for them, the DigiDestined proved why they are still at the top of the pack for the tag team scene and why it's going to take a lot more to keep them down than just that, ladies and gentlemen. A whole lot more than that. But ladies and gentlemen, if you fought, ladies and gentlemen, then that was one way for us to cap off our evening right here and now. Think again, because coming up right now, we're about to hear from our current. We are about to hear from Siegfried von Schroeder as he will effectively make the decision as to what is going on with not just with the Sky. We know about this decision with the Sky High title, but it seems as though he's going to make the clear-cut statement on what the status is for Noctis Lucis Kylam's challenge for the Grand Slam right here and now. And here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, the general manager of Prime, Siegfried von Schroeder, definitely coming out not in the best of moods given what happened last time. We all know that after last Prime, he was scrambling to figure out how to deal with something like this. But I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, if what we heard about the end of Last Prime is any indication, that Siegfried is most certainly a man who has got a lot in his mind and has got a lot of things to say about what has gone on. So, ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, let's hear it. What is a decision that Siegfried von Schroeder has made?
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Siegfried von Schroeder, your ACL Prime General Manager. And I have once again graced your presence tonight to deliver some very, very important announcements coming into our upcoming Grand Slam season. Two announcements pertaining to the Sky High Championship, and one Noctis Lucis Kylam. With the Sky High Championship, it was seemingly vacated at the end of our last show, left out here in the middle of the ring without its owner. The champion of which saying he wished to vacate the title in order to go for the ACL World Championship at the Grand Slam in December. I was originally going to file this as a little spit of the dummy, but the higher-ups have informed me that they have granted the little receiving of the challenge and have deemed Noctis following the guidelines of the World Champions Challenge as accepted. Therefore, as of this moment, the Sky High Championship is vacated. But what of the belt going into Grand Slam? Well, starting tonight and going into the Grand Slam, there will be a weekly series of matches leading into it, where the two who score the most wins leading into the event will face off for the vacant prize of their division. This round-robin-style tournament will run until the final prime of the year, wherein we will find out our participants. Now, as for Noctis Lucis Kylam, as agreed upon with the higher-ups, I am officially saying that his challenge for the World Championship has been accepted. Therefore, at the All-Star Grand Slam 5, it will be Noctis Lucis Kylam facing off against Rock Howard for the World Championship. One on one!
Hell yeah! Hell yeah! This is what it... Oh... Oh my, ladies and gentlemen. If there's anyone that was excited and happy for that announcement to be made, it would definitely be the former Sky High champion and the new number one contender for the ACL World title, who will be facing off against Rock Howard at the Grand Slam for that belt. I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you what! That is a goddamn announcement that has pretty much shaken the entire foundations of Prime going into Grand Slam season, if I do say so myself. Noctis Lucis Kylum has just enacted what may as well be option C for the belt in a big, big way. And it seemingly has been accepted right there. Seemingly. We still have this little interaction to work with, ladies and gentlemen, so let's get back to the ring.
Good to see you finally came to your senses and made a rational choice in the matter, boss. But if I were you, I'd keep your grandstanding to a minimum. Because, as far as I'm concerned, I am going to make sure that you and your little alliance with Kane crumbles when I end Rock Howard's reign at the Grand Slam. But I want to make one thing clear. This little agreement with the board of directors, it doesn't stop with me. I want everyone in the division that holds this belt to get a chance like I have. I've defended it several times over against some of the hardest working performers today, and they all deserve their time as I do. So, I want the same clause applied to them, a limit remover clause, if you will. It is only fair, is it not?
A limit removal. Fitting for such a division that is all about breaking all limits. Wouldn't it just be fitting for that to be the case?
It's strange that you and I are on the same page for once, Noctis. But for this one time only, I shall happily allow this.
Wait, what?! What the hell is Kane doing here?! What on earth is Kane in- Oh, God, Mark of Dignity! Mark of Dignity, but what the hell is Kane doing out here, ruining this summation?
Only if you make it past these three men, of course. See, the board of directors said that your match at the Grand Slam had been accepted, but should you lose to Kane, Shaw, and Davis at final hour, your match and your clause will be dissolved entirely. And as for the grand standing, be sure to replay this, Noctis, when you inevitably lose your shot at world title, like you lost the love of your life so soon.
Of course there'd be a goddamn... Of course there'd be something like this involved! Of course there'd be something like this involved! Noctis gets that match, but at a cost! He has to face off at final hour against Kane and the Prodigies! What a crock of shit!